Hi there, welcome once again to Speed Skating Deconstructed, What Makes a Skater Great. This episode features Tomas Gustafson, one of the greatest distance skaters and all-arounders in the late 70s and early 1980s. Here he is in his 5,000 meter victory, setting a world record, 6:44. He knew what he had to do before this race because Leo Visser from the Netherlands had skated a world record at 6:44, so Tomas knew he had to come under it. So I wanted to show you a few things about what a champion does when you're under pressure. As Tomas was here, Visser was the reigning world all-around champion and just was really, really good all the way through the 80s. So here's Tomas on his opener. I just wanted to see how aggressive he is here. Really getting it going very early because he knew he couldn't lose any time. So it's just a really good, strong opener right from the get-go. You can also already see this nice relaxed timing, straightaways he has. Just a beautiful skater. I want to show you his next turn because it's a better angle. But here he is in his first look at the straightaway. And this great alignment on this blade. Somewhat more in the middle than other skaters, but again, anatomical differences rule. And Tomas had making the use of his best use of his body. Unlike most skaters, he is better going left to right than right to left. Perhaps that's due to no short track experience. A lot of the Americans and North Americans, Canadians, have a lot of short track or indoor ice skating on a small hockey rink. But this is, you can just see. Let's watch it straight away in slow motion for their nice rhythm and timing here. You can just see the power and the rest, and that's the key. In a distance skate race, whatever era you're in, you have to gain rest in the straightaways. Otherwise, you're gonna fall apart. And this is a nice, really relaxed recovery here. Down into the ice on one skate. And then watch moving really early with this. That's the best you can do with a fixed hardtail skate. Just really nice. And he has a nice little flicker at the end. Notice how his ankle turns out. That's to increase the amount of rest. Shaking the leg out, basically, is what Tomas is doing there. He does it on this side, too. So again, really strong. Shifting the weight over to the other side, moving with the lead skate. Good flicker out for rest. So we all have different ways of getting that rest. This was his, and you can see how the recovery skate leads right into the skate he's on for more power. And just great timing. So it's a really beautiful skater without the clap and getting a lot of efficiencies out of his straightaway. And then second thing I really wanted to show you, or third thing, is his turn timing. Trained a lot with Eric Heiden in the summer times and got very strong. And has some of Eric's turn tendencies here. But again, we're looking for one skate on the ice and a drive forward, getting pressure out of the glute, not over swinging the arms. Right is down, left is off. Very clean timing. Let's see if he's driving forward. Nice, that left is down now, right is off. And again, you can see that flicker out. Unique to Tomas, he'd love to just flick that skate out so he can get a little shake out of his glute and his quad and his calf so he can get some rest as he's putting pressure. So remember, you only want to focus on the skate you're on, but you want to have the recovery be part of that power. How you do that is you turn the recovery into a pendulum and thrust it across as you push down. So push down really hard, drive across, and that's a nice forward press there. And again, one skate on the ice. So what I mean about the recovery is it's got to be part of your pressure. So however you can do that, do it. Tomas gets a nice rest here, and then it's all down into the ice, driving forward, one skate, very clean. Very nice turns. Good rhythm, good rest. You can see even his wrist is relaxed. Look at his hand at the back. He even flicks his wrist up. That's all relaxation. However you can get there, get there. Now I want to show you the final thing about this race that's unbelievable. He was doing 32 nines early on in this race. Here's his last lap. Let's watch it in fast motion. He's just digging down for every single thing he has. He's digging down for it. Look at this finish. He knew what he had to do, and he did it 31-8. 31-8. After having done 32 nines in the early part of the race, he negative split the last four laps to end up in a 31-8 and win the race by 0.3 of a second. That's a champion right there, and one of the best under pressure. In addition to this great race itself, Tomas had gone through several things. He had knee injury, his father had passed away, and Tomas had meningitis between 84, where he won a gold and a silver, and 88, where he won two. So an athlete with great adversity and great determination, and we certainly all can learn from that no matter what era we're from. So that's Tomas today, and hope you enjoyed it. Please do subscribe, share with others this channel, coaches, skating fans, skaters, and I will see you next time. Oh, please comment too. Thanks. All right. Talk to you soon. Bye.